What's going on, guys? We are back with another video. We got Mr. Lewis, the Pro Charge Beast, and we got the dyno open, and we got the Beast here. But this is actually Beast 2.0. I think Lewis was making a video on his channel about all that happened. But basically, this is not the same car that you guys have known, although it looks pretty damn close. The paint actually looks better than the other car. Currently, this is naturally aspirated. And it's E85. I tuned this car maybe a month ago or something like that. Yep. 93, I gave him a ghost cam tune, and now it's on E85. We're gonna put it on the dyno, and I'm gonna make some tune adjustments because we didn't really go too crazy on the tune. I just gave it to him. We haven't logged it yet. So we're gonna get it on the dyno, do a baseline hit, and then make some adjustments. And then next up is getting the Pro Charger put back on it. Right. So right now it's just NA tuning. I've tuned a bunch of these GT350s now remote, and they seem to pick up really good power. So we're gonna back it on the dyno, get it going, and have some fun. So here's the Beast 2.0 MGW 3160 digital cluster. Nice. Let's get it backed onto the dyno.
You're good. Yeah, it's not as low as the other. Watch that wheel.
So I sent Lewis a base E85 startup run drive, and he was breaking in the clutch. So this one has no real, you know, go fast stuff in it yet. So we're just gonna run it and see what it does on, you know, basic the base file, and then we'll go ahead and make some improvements.
All right. Cool.
That's a dyno brake. Dude. 483.
What?
483.
483?
On my bass tune.
On the bass tune. Nice.
Dude, look at this. 483. You remember Kevin's car back in the day and it was struggling to make like 440, 450?
Yep. Hey, look at that. You didn't, no changes, no nothing.
Didn't change anything.
Nothing. Bass.
Dude, that's sick.
That's awesome. Cool.
Alright, now I'm gonna look at the look. Dude, sick.
What was the torque? Did I say the torque?
Torque was 407.
Okay.
Which we know voodoos don't really make that much torque.
Correct.
But I think we got some room for improvement, so that's gonna be sweet. So I'm gonna make some tune changes and then we'll be back at it.
Alright.
Alright, so a few tune changes, just to kind of get a little bit more timing in there, and we'll see what it does.
Sounded healthy.
489.
489. Those little changes like that just picked up some good power.
Oh yeah. Yeah, 489, 411 on the torque. So we picked up a little bit of torque too. Tiny bit, 407 to 411.
Okay.
But yeah, just gonna do the same thing. Look at the log, make some improvements. I'm basically slowly stepping it in and building my timing table. If anyone knows anything about the Gen 2, Gen 3 cars, there's 25 different map points. So the cheap and easy way is basically to add to the lambda adder. I don't like to do that. I like to make sure all the timing tables
are working with each other. It's a different timing tables for different pieces of teaching. So, yeah. We're just going to build out those timing tables so the tune's really good. And then I know exactly what this file is going to make on any car all around the country. No timing difference.
No timing, okay.
There's a little bit of fuel.
$491, $412. Okay.
Pretty good. Alright, so we're making about $490 and it really doesn't have much timing in it, but we're starting to see fuel kind of run away up top, and I've done everything in my power to get that fuel under control, and I started thinking to myself, GT350s have basically the same injectors as the GT cars, but they run a higher fuel pressure because they have the twin pumps. So the thing of the injector might be tapped out, so I consulted my buddy Robbie Shoemaker, and I just gave him a call, and I said, yo, when do these injectors tap out on the 350s? And he's like, yeah, right about there. Some of them make more, some of them make less, but we're making about 490. So we're just making another run. We tried a few more things with, there's a fuel pump limit patch on the OS, didn't fix it. So we're just gonna make one final pull. Lewis is going Pro Charger, so he's not gonna change these injectors. And it's not a dangerous leak condition, it's just, it's not where we want it to be. So it's in above like 7,500 RPM. So we're gonna make another run, see what it does. Positive on the injector being out. You know, for one, the cars are a little old, the injector's a little bit different, fuel pumps are a little bit different, but air is different. We're just running out of injectors. So I just made some minor changes that I want to do so that I have it for my tune for when I send it out to maybe one of you guys to make sure it's good. Something that we're going to have to watch for in the future is probably going to need LU47 when you start knocking on the door of 500, because these are the same injectors as the regular Coyote. We're making one more pull. I don't know if it's going to make more or less. I didn't really change much. I just want to make sure everything's smooth. The one thing I always hated whenever I had in my car is dyno tune, and not knocking anyone that did this, but we would always make a pull, then they would make one more change, put it in the car, and they'd say, oh, no, we're all good. But I always like to make the change, run the car, because I never want to put something in the car that I wouldn't want the customer to be out there having fun with. So we're going to run it one more time, make sure it's all good, safe, everything's looking good. Like I said, injector's running out up top, so if Lewis does want to keep it NA, he would need to get some LU47s. Otherwise, when he puts the Pro Charger in ID1300s, we won't have any problems. And you can actually see the power start to level out as the fuel starts to kind of, it's not that it's running away and lean, but it's not my target. Some people run these at 8.5, 8.8 lambda. I would not. I find that these cars are much safer at an 8.2, 8.3 lambda, 8.5 maybe, but like 8.8, no way, not doing that. But 488, it's made as much as 491. We didn't add any timing there. That was just to make sure that we have a nice, smooth data log, no knock, just happy. So we're gonna call it there. I'd love to do the injector swap, but you know, the boost is coming. So we got a GT350. Let's do some LU47 and we'll put it on the dyno and we'll make 500. So we're just looking here. This thing has a lot of room. I mean, it's not a boosted car, right? But if you look at peak power here, where we're starting to see, you know, the layover and everything at 7,200 RPM,
Typically, I'd see this at 75, 76, but we're having that fuel just kind of dip out. If you look at the log here, you know, we're only seeing a max of 26 degrees. You can see that I have my target, the 8.2, it follows it, and then it just starts to run away. And then at 7,200, we're only at 26 and a half degrees. If you guys know anything about this, 31 is kind of your magic number on coyotes. And so we're 4.5 degrees off of, you know, where peak timing is. Just because I'm not going to add the timing in if the fuel's not there to support it. But, yeah, 488, 491. And that was pretty good over our original, 483, and we've done so. There you go. Yeah, that was just a tiny bit of timing difference. So 493 493 or 490, and there's another one that's 491, same thing. Now I would expect to see basically this curve start out a little bit higher right here, and I expect to see it to kind of just tap over 500. So with that 4.5 degrees that we have to work with, I'd expect to see the about 10 horsepower. And if it really likes that timing, which sometimes these coyotes, like, and this is a little, but same thing. You get into that peak timing efficiency area, and it might make 20 more with that 4.5 degrees, but it also might only make like 5 more. So, you know, overall, make really good power. We know what we would need to tweak to get it to that 500 mark, but the beast is, it's here, you know?
It's NA.
Yep.
Soon to boost.
So if you guys want to pick up some tunes or whatever, I can remote tune them, whatever. The more I tune in person, the easier the remote tuning gets, but, you know, everything I've tuned remote, a lot of it has been, you know, a little bit from basically scratch, starting out, ASIM data logs, you can dial everything in to be perfect. Fuel trim's perfect within like 3%. I see a lot of the mainstream tuners, which there's nothing super wrong with this, but they rely heavily on long-term fuel trims, correcting that 10% variance based on your weather, your fuel, your combo, just every car is slightly different. So I just really dial them in to, you know, 2-3%, so that way I look at a log and it's just perfect. All right, so we went to lunch, late lunch, and sometimes my brain's just like, seems a little weird that we're out of injector. We looked up a bunch of different dyno graphs. I called my three go-to friend, tuna friends, Rob, Joe Goodenough, Rob Shoemaker, Joe Goodenough, and Brett Lundquist, all of which are good tuners. Just ran it by them. Maybe we're out of injector, maybe there's a table, but I ran through the tune and I couldn't find any good answer. It's just running away on fuel. We're going to try to see if we can slam some more fuel into it by targeting a lower lambda target, see if it fixes it. And the car's already on the dyno, so why not test it?
That's it.
Yeah. I know what's wrong with it.
Ain't got no gas in it.
Ain't got no gas.
Final pull of the night. Let's see what it did. This is the final pull.
494.
Alrighty.
So we got a pretty good handle on it. I called my friend Brett again, and so injector pulse width, I wasn't logging before, and now I logged them the last two runs, and there's a calculated duty cycle. So for one, I commanded more fuel than normal to try to see if we can, you know, make some more fuel. And then we're tapped out on injector. So on that last run, we were at 115 duty cycle. Right here, we're at 106.
Okay.
We are 100% certified out of injector. Including, so you can see over here, driver demand limit, insufficient fuel flow. It's literally detecting, and this is because I'm commanding 7.5 lambda, and it will not get to 7.5 lambda. But
We are 100% certified without a doubt out of injector. We are hitting anywhere from 100 to 115% injector duty cycle. We make great power, but I have to lift a little early because it starts to go lean, and I only have 27 degrees of timing into it still. We ended up making 420 torque, 494 power, and I would pretty much put money on if we had the proper fuel flow, we could make probably right at 505 to 510.
Yep.
And it, even on the conservative side, it would make that 500 mark.
Yep. Perfect.
So if Lewis was keeping this NA, I say, hey, dude, go get some LU-47s. We'll put it right, you know, we can swap it right here on the dyno.
Yep.
But he's been the pro charger, so yep. It's not going to matter. But it's really healthy. I know that my tune's good, because I was second-guessing myself, and I'm like, okay, is there something I'm missing here? But the injector duty cycle tells the truth. 115% duty cycle. That's not it, Chief.
Yep, that's it. All right. Well, we got the final numbers here for now until the boost goes by next week, and then we'll put it back on.
That's 494 horsepower naturally aspirated, 27 degree peak timing. I mean, we run like 20 degrees off the hit. It's not much. So, and you can see the graph's smooth.
Yes, very
other
smooth.
Than right at the end, but that's usually where I start to lift, right? I'm not even running this out to 8,000 because we can't.
Yeah.
It's running out of fuel. So, yeah. Thanks to my friends, Joe, Rob, and Brett. I consulted all of them on it, even though this was the original thought, but I want to consult them to see what their thoughts are. All right, guys. So, I hope you enjoyed the video on Lewis's car. We didn't quite crack the 500, but I think that it would have cracked the 500, but we're just out of injector. Every car is a little bit different. It happens sometimes. We are going to put Blake's car on the dyno. I'll drop one clip in here before we wrap up this video. If you guys need a GT352, let me know. If we do get close to that 500 mark, we may be talking about injectors because I have consulted with three different guys. They all pretty much agreed with me. And then we got our final injector duty cycle, 115%. That's tapped. He might just have some really good E85 in it. It might be the reason why it's running out sooner than later. But anyways, 494 horsepower. If you put LU-47s in, we'd be good to go. But anyways, hit that like button down below. Comment, let us know what you think, and we'll see you guys in the next one.